Welcome everyone to Race to IAS Current Affairs Guru. I hope everybody is doing good. We will be discussing the important current events of last week, that is from March 22 to 29. Okay. The first one is regarding the olive ridley turtles. What are olive ridley turtles? They are the smallest and the most abundant species of sea turtles found in the world. They are also listed as vulnerable species in the IUCN red list in appendix 1 in CITES or Convention of International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, which means it cannot be traded commercially internationally, and in Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, which means anyone trying to cause any danger for these turtles will be severely punished by Indian government. Usually turtles go for nesting, means coming ashore for laying eggs during night time when there is not much disturbance from humans or other kinds of interferences. But very unusually, in fact after a gap of 7 years, olive ridley turtles have come ashore for daytime nesting in India. And where did they come for this daytime nesting? At Rishikulya Rookery Coast in Odisha. The most interesting thing about their nesting is that they do it as a huge group together, and this mass nesting event is called Aribada. So what is Aribada? It is a mass nesting event when thousands of turtles come ashore at the same time to lay eggs on the same shore. So that's all about olive ridley turtle and their mass nesting. So moving on. The next is regarding air quality in quarantine countries. The US Space Agency, NASA, and the European Space Agency observed that air quality is improving in countries under coronavirus quarantine. In fact, images by the US Space Agency NASA found that in February, the concentration of nitrogen dioxide or NO2 fell dramatically in Wuhan, China, the epicenter of the COVID-19 pandemic, passing from an indicator that was red or orange to blue. The red indicator usually shows that an area is under severe air pollution, while a blue-colored indicator shows that the area is less polluted. The European Space Agency, which does similar observations in Europe, observed a striking reduction in pollution levels in northern Italy, which has been locked down. And what is NO2? NO2 or nitrogen dioxide is an air pollutant which is emitted by vehicles, industrial sites, and thermal power stations. It can cause serious damage to the respiratory system. Now, thanks to the lockdown, we are observing a reduction in the concentration of the pollutant. Next is regarding section 144 of CRPC or Criminal Procedure Code. Nowadays, we see frequently in news that the district collector or of a particular area has declared section 144 in that area, right? So why do they do that? What does section 144 do? It generally prohibits public gathering. It prohibits the assembly of 4 or more people in that area. It is generally used by the district administration to prevent any possible rioting that may cause trouble or damage to human life or property. According to the law, every member of such unlawful assembly can be arrested for engaging in rioting. Recently, Section 144 was declared in many parts of the country to prevent the gathering of people in order to prevent the spread of coronavirus. So this is the more details regarding Section 144 of CRPC. So those who want can post their video and read it. So the next is regarding World Meteorological Day. It is observed on 23rd March worldwide every year. So what is meteorology? It is the study of atmosphere and the forecasting weather. So by observing 23rd March as World Meteorological Day, we underline the efforts of National Meteorological and Hydrological Services of this for the safety and well-being of the society. The World Meteorological Day this year has got a theme, and it is water and climate change. In fact, this year's World Water Day also shares the same theme, that is water and climate change. Now, the meteorological activities around the world are coordinated by an organization called World Meteorological Organization or WMO. The World Meteorological Organization is an intergovernmental organization with its headquarters in Geneva, Switzerland, which is in Switzerland. The World Meteorological Organization has a membership of 191 member states and territories. Okay, so moving on. Next is regarding World Tuberculosis Day or TB Day. So tuberculosis or TB is a serious infectious bacterial disease that mainly affects the lungs. It is usually caused by bacteria called Mycobacterium tuberculosis. World Tuberculosis Day is observed globally on 24th March every year to raise public awareness about the devastating health, social and economic consequences of TB and to step up efforts to end the global TB epidemic. The theme of World TB Day of 2020 is, it is time. Next is regarding Tokyo Olympics of 2020. Where is Tokyo? It is in Japan and in fact the capital of Japan. Due to the coronavirus outbreak, the 2020 Olympics is now decided to be postponed to a date no later than the summer of 2021. The games were originally scheduled for July 24 to August 9. Now, in the past also, Olympics has seen unexpected reschedules in Tokyo. It pulled out from hosting the 1940 Olympics due to the international pressure over its war with China at that time during 1940s. Next is regarding the first made in India COVID-19 test kit to get CDSCO approval. It is made by MyLab Discovery Solutions Private Limited and is called MyLab Patho Detect COVID-19 Qualitative PCR Kit. It can be used to check if the patient have coronavirus infection or not. So what is CDSCO or the Central Drug Standard Control Organization do? It is the national regulatory body for Indian pharmaceutical and medical devices. You will need to obtain the approval of CDSCO to sell any drug or medical equipment in India. So the next is regarding hantavirus. Now the world is under a huge crisis due to novel coronavirus which emerged from China. Last week, a report regarding a man dying due to hantavirus in China itself caused a lot of fear and concern worldwide. So what is this hantavirus? They are different from the coronavirus and are a family of viruses spread mainly by rodents like rats, mice or squirrels. It is not a new virus like coronavirus and was discovered for the first time during the Korean War of 1950-53. Scientists say it doesn't spread from human to human like coronavirus and that there is no need to panic. The mechanism of spread and its symptoms in humans are given in detail in the slides. Those who want can pause the video and read it. So the next is regarding the lockdown financial aid announced by the central government. We all know that the government has announced a 21-day lockdown to prevent the spread of coronavirus in the country, right? But during this lockdown, many people, especially the poor and vulnerable, will lose their employment or they will not be having enough money to buy food items or groceries during this period. In order to help them and to boost the economy, the central government has announced a 1.7 lakh crore rupees lockdown package. What all are the components of this package? You can see it listed in the slide. It ranges from insurance coverage to medical workers to wage increases for MGNREGA workers. Those who want can pause the video and read it in details. Next is regarding the special announcements by RBI to manage the impacts of coronavirus outbreak in the economy. So what all are the special announcements by RBI? It has cut the repo rate by 0.75% to 4.4%. The reverse repo rate was cut by 90 basis points to 4%. And a moratorium, that is temporary halt in the payment of interest for all term loan repayments for 3 months, was also announced. Now what is repo rate? It is the interest rate at which commercial banks gets loans from RBI. Now, if the repo rate is low, banks can take loans from RBI at lower rates than usual and can thus give loans to businessmen and consumers at lower rate. How does this help the economy? The businessmen will start new business with this money and consumers will buy new things like a new vehicle or homes. This will energize the economy. Reverse repo is the just opposite of repo and it is the interest rate at which RBI takes loans from banks. Since RBI now gives only low interest to banks, the banks will lend their money to the businessmen and consumers rather than to RBI. This will again energize the economy. And as you all know, a halt in the payment of interest will be a huge relief to poor people who have taken loans from the banks, as they will be short of money during this lockdown period. The details regarding repo and reverse repo are given in the following slides and those who want can pause the video to read. The next news item says that India also joins World Health Organization's COVID-19 drug trials. We all know that all over the world, countries are frantically researching for an effective medicine to treat the coronavirus infection. Since it is a novel or a new strain of virus, no existing medicine is effective against it. The WHO is the leading organization in this research to find an effective drug for the disease. And India also has now joined WHO's solidarity trial to find out the drug. The solidarity trial will test 4 different drugs or combinations. In the next news item, we see that Goa becomes the first state to launch a self-assessment tool for COVID-19. It is called Test Yourself Goa. This tool helps people identify if they are infected by the virus without visiting a doctor or a hospital. The Goa government developed this tool by partnering with Innovaxer, a US-based healthcare data analytics company. Next, we see that Indian Army has started Operation Namaste to combat COVID-19. The Army Chief M.M. Naravane has launched this operation where the Army will help the government of India to fight against the deadly disease. So remember the name of the operation, that is Operation Namaste. Next is regarding CARES Fund announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. CARES Fund stands for Citizens Assistance and Relief in Emergency Situations Fund. Last week, we saw our Prime Minister giving shape to a SARC fund to fight against the COVID-19 pandemic in South Asian region, right? Likewise, he has now established a domestic fund for donations to India's war against COVID-19. It is for dealing with any kind of emergencies or distress situation like the current COVID-19 pandemic and to provide relief to the affected people. The Prime Minister will be the chairman of this trust and its members include Defence Minister, Home Minister and Finance Minister. So how can anyone contribute to this fund? You can go to the website pmindia.gov.in and donate to PM CARES Fund using the guidelines given there. Further details of the fund are given in the slide. Those who want can pause the slide and read. Next is regarding the National Teleconsultation Center called CONTECT, launched by the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare. So what is CONTECT? CONTECT or COVID-19 National Telecommunication Center is a telemedicine hub established by AIMS or All India Institute of Medical Science, New Delhi, wherein expert doctors from various clinical domains will be available 24/7 to answer the multifaceted questions from specialists from all over the country. Through this, two-way audio, video and text communications can be undertaken from anywhere in the country or from anywhere in the world. The modes of communication will include simple mobile telephony as well as two-way video communication using WhatsApp, Skype and Google Duo. So that's all for this week, guys. Hope all of you like this session. If yes, don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe buttons. Okay. You can get timely updates from Race to IAS by following us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok and Hilo. The links are provided in the description box below. Also, download our Junior IAS app from Play Store for daily current affairs, mock tests and quiz. See you next week, guys. Stay safe. Goodbye.